Hi, my name is Carrie Levitt-Bussian, and I'm the Paleontology Collections Manager here at the Natural History Museum of Utah. We are back behind the scenes in our collection space, where I have about 65,000 fossils behind me in these cabinets. It's really special that we're back here, and I'm going to be showing you some of my favorite fossils today. So what I have in front of me here are bones from Stegosaurus stenops. So that is an herbivorous dinosaur that lived 150 million years ago. And so what I have here is the skull of an animal that's called Camptosaurus, but it looks really similar to Stegosaurus. And you can see that they are both herbivorous dinosaurs based on looking at their short, stubby teeth. What's really neat about Stegosaurus is that he is very iconic. It has the plates along its back and the tail spikes on its tail. So what we have here is a tail spike. And it would have been really straight in real life, but due to the fossilization, it has actually been skewed and bent a little bit. But they would have had a couple of these on the back of its tail, making it a very vicious weapon. And what I have next is an Allosaurus vertebra. So this is part of its backbone. But what's neat about it is that it has this hole right here. And some researchers have hypothesized that this hole was made by this Stegosaurus tail spike. So this thing would have been in a fight, Stegosaurus versus Allosaurus, and the Stegosaurus would have whacked its tail really hard and punctured this Allosaurus vertebra. So that's kind of interesting to see. And you can see the bone has become all rugose trying to heal itself. So I wonder who won that battle. And then the plates along the back. And so that's what we have here. And what's really neat about this is for a while we all thought that the plates ran perfectly along its spine, but now we know that it alternates from right to left to right to left. And then also what's really neat is you can see these striations, these marks that are vertical, and we think that those are from blood vessels. And so what we think this animal did was it would pump blood into its plates and then face into the wind, and then it would be able to cool off a little bit with the thermoregulation. So that's a really neat hypothesis too. So Stegosaurus is one of everybody's favorite dinosaurs in the Jurassic, and it's one of mine for sure. This cabinet is filled with bones from Allosaurus fragilis, which is a meat-eating dinosaur from the Jurassic. And what is really neat is it comes from Cleveland Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry, which is near Price in Utah. And what's really unique about Cleveland Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry is it's a bone bed. So it has a bunch of different fossils from different dinosaurs, and almost all of those fossils have been disarticulated, which means it's not in life position. So I'm going to show you a couple of the cool fossils from Allosaurus. So this is a right maxilla. So this is the cheek bone right here, and it has teeth in it, which is really, really neat. And so it has serrations on the teeth, so more evidence supporting that it's a carnivorous dinosaur. But what's really cool is we have both adults and juveniles found at the same place. And so we have both the adult maxilla and the juvenile maxilla. So you can see the huge size difference. You can also see the size difference with their claws. So this is a claw of an adult, and this is a claw of a juvenile. So it's the same anatomical element, but they have their different sizes. And then this is one of the coolest things I think we have in our collections. This is an Allosaurus brain. So what that means is it's an Allosaurus endocast. And what happened is the Allosaurus dinosaur died, and then its brain left the brain cavity, and then it was infilled or filled up with sediment. And that sediment became fossilized. And so this is what is left. And so how they got it out was they actually had a brain case, and they opened up the brain case and found this perfectly complete cast of a brain. So now we actually take dinosaur skulls to the hospitals where they have a CT scanner machine, and they can actually CT scan the skull, and we can see the hole where the brain would go and kind of hypothesize what it might have looked like. But here we actually have a three-dimensional sediment cast of an Allosaurus fragilis brain. So here are some bones from Ceratosaurus. It's also a dinosaur from the Jurassic, and it's a carnivorous dinosaur, as you can tell by the pointy teeth. So what's also really neat about Ceratosaurus, and particularly this animal, is it's one of the most complete ones in the entire world, and one of the largest ones in the entire world. What's also cool about it is that this guy had armor on it. So usually you think of body armor for herbivorous dinosaurs like Stegosaurus or Ankylosaurus, but this is a carnivorous dinosaur that had body armor. So it had a horn on its nose, over its eye, and then down its back, down its spine, and that's what you see here. Each one of these pieces called osteoderms would have been down its back. So that's really cool, very ornamented. And then we have the maxilla, which is the cheekbone. So this is the left side with the pointy teeth. And then we have, this is really neat, this is called the premaxilla. So it attaches here in the maxilla. And what's so cool about it is we have both the left and the right side. And so you can see both teeth, and you can see like the upper roof of its mouth, which is very cool. And then we have the denary. So this is the lower jawbone. And so you can see it has some of its teeth preserved. There would have been teeth all along here during its lifetime. And it's very pointed, and the teeth are very serrated. So you can use your imagination to see how this guy would go chomp, 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 and eat whatever it wanted to. Only a small fraction of the specimens that are housed in a museum ever go out on exhibit. Most of them are stored in collection spaces like this one for research. It was so great to show some of them to you today.